This summer, I was in Wayne, Nebraska, and I was in South Dakota working on a youth basketball camp, and I got a text message from Chase, which not out of the common that players text me over the summer asking me questions, but this text message was unique. It was saying, "Coach, I got this idea about making an impact, not just in Burwell, but across the state." And immediately I said, "What's up? Let me know. Text me." I was with a friend who was a fellow coach, and with what Chase shared with me really hit me, and it really hit us, and it was something that I knew Chase was a special guy and a leader and selfless and was just an extreme special person before this, and just showing his maturity and the impact that he really wants to have and how selfless he truly is stood out with what he's about to tell you guys.
Well, I was at the Nebraska Agricultural Youth Institute, and while I was there, we listened to a bunch of speakers about how we are the future leaders of not just Nebraska, but the world. And I thought, well, I can make an impact when I get out of college, but can I make an impact now? And so I thought of this thing called Blackout Cancer. And Blackout Cancer is where all the participating teams from across the state will wear the same warm-up shirts, and they will sell these same shirts to their communities across the state. The proceeds from these shirts will be donated to the University of Nebraska Medical Center this year for cancer research. This is our annual fundraiser, so this is our very first year. And I thought, well, I need some help with this because I've got the idea, but I don't know how to put it all together. So that's where talking to Mr. Stolzer came in to play.
You know, when we got back, we got to work on it. It was a slow process to start, you know, football, school, and everything going on, but really started to take form when we sent out emails to school. Chase and I both contacted surrounding communities. I reached out to fellow coaches that I knew, and this thing has just taken off. We're up to 15 schools who are participating, most in central Nebraska, but there's some schools on the eastern part of the state as well. And you know, with competition, we're normally going against each other, you know, two teams battling versus each other. But with this, we're rallying everybody together to compete against one common opponent. And that one common opponent is cancer. And this is where everybody can rally together, put their resources together to make a difference, because cancer is something that we're all affected by. I mean, anymore, the big C is something that we hear all too often. And you know, Craig Sager, who just passed away, said, you know, one day we're going to wipe out cancer. And it all started back with Jim Valvano with don't give up, don't ever give up. And this is just our part to, as Stuart Scott said, fight like hell and do whatever it takes. And when you get too tired, let somebody else fight. So for those people who are too tired to fight or who can no longer fight, this is just our part. And that's a lot of communities coming together and unifying for one common opponent.
When you go and talk to just anybody on the street, any common person, the odds are that they will know someone that has either been affected by cancer or know a friend of theirs whose family has been affected by cancer. I personally know four people that have been infected. My grandfather is a cancer survivor, an adult friend of our family is a cancer survivor, and a girl that went to my high school also survived cancer. My uncle was unfortunately not that lucky, and he died of brain cancer. So as far as cancer, it's all around us. We just need to look for a way to somehow stop it. And by getting proceeds for the University of Nebraska Medical Center and just more money for cancer research, we can somehow find a way to end this horrible disease, make a difference